सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंतां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। ओम सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ओम शांति शांति शांति। अखंडम सच्चिदानंदम अवांग मनस गोचरम आत्मानमखिलाधारम आश्रयेधीष्ट सिद्धये अर्थतोप्यद्वयानंदान अतीतद्वैत भानतः गुरुनाराध्य वेदांत सारं वक्षे यथामति।
What is the summary of yesterday?
We were seeing the topic of Sukshma Sharira creation, and in that topic we are started yesterday with Karmendriyani, Vak, Pani, Pada, Payu, Payu, Sthakhyani.
Pani, Payu?
Vak, Pani, Pada, Payu, Pasthakhyani. So here we are seeing the Karmendriyas, which are the part of Sukshma Sharira. This says the organs of action are the ones which are called Vak, organ of speech, Pani, hand, Pada, legs, Payu, organ of excretion, Upastha, organ of genital organ. And then Etani Punah Akashadinam Rajonshebhyah Yastebhyah Pruthak Pruthak Pramena Utpadyante. Etani refers to Karmendriyani. Punah, but or on the other hand, this organs of action are born from the individual rajasic aspects of the Akashadi Mahabhutas, and they are born separately and in order. And here this order can be taken as from Akasha, Vagindriya is born, from Vayu, Panindriya is born, and so on. This is the order. And then the author described the pranas, which are the part of Sukshma Sharira. So first, the pranas, the names of the pranas are given. Vayavah, prana, pana, vyano, dana, samanaha. The five vital airs are prana, apana, vyana, udana, and samana. And the author himself will describe each of them. We will see them at that time. So first, pranaha nama, pragamanavan, प्राग्गमनवान नासाग्र स्थानवर्ती वायुः। प्राण means the air or the vital air which is going outside and which is staying on the
going outside, going in front,
which is going in front and which stays on the tip of the nose. Now here the author seems has defined prana as mainly the exhaled air, and this can be seen as the exhaled air can be seen as representing the entire respiratory system. Then, apano nama avagamanavan payavadi sthanavarti vayuhu. Apana means the vital air or air which is going down and which is staying in the genital organ, etc.
Payu means?
Which is staying in the organ of excretion, etc. And by adi we have to understand upastha also. So apana is the vital energy responsible for the excretory system. Vyano nama vishvagamanavan akhila sharira varti vayuhu. Vyana means the vital air, which is going all over the body and which is staying in the entire body. So this is can be seen as vyana, can be seen as the vital energy responsible for the circulatory system.
Circulatory means the system which is circulating the nutrients to all the parts of the body.
Then udanaha nama kanthasthaniyaha urdhvagamanavan utkramana vayuhu. Udana means the air, vital air, which is staying in the throat, which is going upwards and which is responsible for pushing things outside the body. So this can be seen as the vital energy responsible for or dealing with the ejectory system. Then samano nama sharira madhyagata ashita pitanari samikarana karaha. The samana means the vital air which is staying in the middle part of the body and which is responsible or which is the agent of assimilating food etc. which is eaten and drunk. And now the author further explains what does samikarana karaha means or what does samikaranam means. Samikaranam tu paripaka karanam rasa rudhira shukra purishadi karanam iti yavat. Samikaranam tu paripaka karanam. By assimilation here complete cooking or complete digestion is meant, and that is further explained. What does paripaka karanam means? It means making or converting the food into rasa,
food and drinks,
the eaten and drunk food and drinks into rasa, kail, rudhira, blood, shukra, semen, purisha, excreta, adi can be taken as majja, etc. Iti yavat, this is the meaning. So by assimilation complete digestion is meant, and by that the conversion of eaten and drunk food into the constituents of the body. This is the final meaning. Then incidentally the author mentions the views of Sankhya philosophers. Kechittu Naga Kurma Krukala Devadatta Dhananjaya Khyaha Pancha Anye Vayavaha Santi Iti Vadanti. Kechit refers to Sankhyaha. On the other hand, some people, that is Sankhyaha, say that there are five other airs. And what are they? They are Naga, Kurma, Krupala, Devadatta, Dhananjayaha. Having these names, Akhyaha, Iti Vadante. So, according to them, there are 10 pranas. Five which we saw earlier and five which are said in this paragraph. And then further, what are those each type of prana? They are explained. Tatra nagaha udgirana karaha. Tatra, among those five pranas, nagaha. The naga prana is the agent for belching. Purmaha unmilana karaha. Purmaha is the agent for opening the eyes and by upalakshana closing as well. Krukalaha shutkaraha. Krukalaha is responsible for hunger. Devadattaha jumbana karaha. Devadatta prana is responsible for yawning. Dhananjayaha poshana karaha. Dhananjaya prana is responsible for nourishment. And now author gives what is the stand of Vedantins regarding this. Etesham pranadishu antarbhavat pranadayah pancha eva iti kechit. Here kechit refers to Vedantinah. Some people, that is Vedantis, say that of all these since there is inclusion of all these five pranas in the five main pranas only.
You can say, since there is inclusion of subsidiary prana into the main prana.
Since there is a inclusion of subsidiary pranas in the main pranas, pranadayah pancha eva. the pranas are five only.
Then, and main basis is Shruti. Okay. And earlier, etani punaha 76. Etani punaha akashadinam rajomsha. Then punaha is but, however, to show the distinction from the buddhi manasi and also gnanendriyas. Gnanendriyas and the mind, intellect are born of sattvic aspect of sukshma mahabhutas, whereas, but etani means karmendriyani. So in that manner there is a distinction. So punaha shows the distinction of this karmendriyani being born of rajasic aspect compared to the other ones, gnanendriyanis and the mind. Is it clear? Okay. Then yesterday I was referring to one Brahma Sutra. The sutra is Navayu Kriye Prithag Upadeshat 249. That prana is neither vayu nor kriya. Why? Separately mentioned. Where is separately mentioned? Etasmat jayate prana manas sarvendriyani cha. So prana is separately mentioned apart from the indriyas, kriyatmaka indriyas. Etasmat jayate prana manas sarvendriyani cha. So it is separately mentioned. Etasmat jayate prana manas sarvendriyani cha. Kham vayu jyotirapaha prithivi vishvasya dharini. So kham vayu. Vayu is separately mentioned and indriyas are separately mentioned. So indriyas represent the activity. And vayu of course is there. Air. So both of them are mentioned separately apart from prana. Etasma jayate prana. Prana is mentioned and then vayu is separately mentioned. Indriyas are separately mentioned. And therefore, na vayu kriye prana. Sutra will, the vayu kriye prithak upadeshat, we have to supply pranaha na vayu kriye. Prana is neither vayu nor it is just only activity. Means indriyas. It is why prithak upadeshat separately mentioned. So 249. Okay. Now pancha pranas were mentioned, pancha upapranas were mentioned, and now this pranas, which are finally decided to be five, they are born of Rajasikamsa. That is said in the next paragraph. Etat pranadi panchakam.
Etat pranadi panchakam.
Akashadikata rajomshebhyaha.
Akashadikata rajomshebhyaha.
Militebhyaha utpadyate.
Militebhyaha utpadyate.
They should be separate. Utpadyate, singular is used because etat pranadi panchakam. This group of five pranas, this group of five starting with prana, etat pranadi panchakam, utpadyate is born. This group of five prana etc. is born of what? Rajomshebhyaha, from the rajasic aspect. Where are the rajasic aspect? Where is the rajasic aspect? Akashadi gata, obtaining in the rajasic aspect related to obtaining in akashadi, obtaining in the five sukshma mahabhutas starting with akasha. In simple words, pranadi panchaka is born of rajasic aspect of sukshma mahabhutas. But this sattvic, rajasic, tamasic aspect, they are of two types. One is vyashti, the vyasta and samasta, milita. So here militebhyah utpadyate. Militebhyah means from combined. Pranadi panchaka, a group of five pranas, is born of combined rajasic aspect of akashadi elements. Karmendriyas are also born of rajasic aspect, but there prithak prithak vyastebhyah, दिस इज मिलितेभ्यः ओके उत्पद्यते दैट इज वाई दिस प्राणास कैन हेल्प ऑल कर्मेंद्रियास बिकॉज दे आर बॉर्न ऑफ ऑल द राजसिक एस्पेक्ट ऑफ ऑल महाभूतास देयरफॉर मिलितेभ्यः उत्पद्यते ऑलराइट देन ही कनेक्ट्स दिस डिस्क्रिप्शन विद द कोशा एंड ही सेज इदं प्राणादिपञ्चकम् कर्मेन्द्रियैः सहितं सत् सॉरी कर्मेन्द्रियैः सहितं सत् प्राणमयकोशः भवति इदं प्राणादिपञ्चकम् दिस् ग्रूप् आफ् फाइव अस्य क्रियात्मकत्वेन रजोंशकार्यत्वम् इदं प्राणादिपञ्चकम् दिस् ग्रूप् आफ् फाइव प्राणास् बिगिनिङ्ग् वित् प्राण कर्मेन्द्रियैः सहितम् अलोङ्ग् वित् कर्मेन्द्रियास् अलोङ्ग् वित् दि आर्गन्स् आफ् एक्शन् सहितं सत् बीङ्ग् एकम्पनीड् बै बीङ्ग् अलोङ्ग् वित् दीस् आर्गन्स् आफ् एक्शन् प्राणमयः प्राणमयकोशः भवति बिकम्स् प्राणमयकोश फैव् प्राणास् प्लस् कर्मेन्द्रियास् बोथ् आफ् देम् पुट् टुगेदर् कान्स्टिट्यूट् मेक् प्राणमयकोशः एण्ड् प्राणमयकोश अगेन् वी केन् सी प्राणमय मीन्स् कन्सिस्टिङ्ग् आफ् प्राणास् देर्फोर् प्राणमय एण्ड् कोशवत् आच्छादकत्वात् कोशः सो प्राण आल्सो बिकम्स् द बेसिस् फार् कमिटिङ्ग् मिस्टेक् अबौट् द सेल्फ् देट्स् वै इस् ऐ एम् हङ्ग्री ऐ एम् थर्स्टी ऐ एम् वीक् ऐ एम् नाट् एबल् टु डैजेस्ट् मै फुड् पीपल् से देट् that you know people give me so much food very high quality food but I am not able to digest then what is you are not digesting you are atma chaitanya who is sakshi of prana but you say I am not digesting I can digest any stone also somebody some people say that anything so this is what committing a mistake about oneself identifying with the prana so prana becomes the basis for committing a mistake about oneself therefore it is called koshah I am kshut pipasa rahitah I am free from kshut hunger and thirst but I consider myself to be hungry and thirsty and thus prana becomes the basis therefore it is koshah so pranamayatvat means प्राणैः रचितत्वात् एण्ड् कोशवत् आच्छादकत्वात् प्राणमयकोशः ऑलराइट देन् अस्य क्रियात्मकत्वेन अस्य मीन्स् प्राणमयकोशस्य क्रियात्मकत्वेन बिकास् आफ् बीयिङ्ग् आफ् द नेचर् आफ् एक्टिविटि सिन्स् दिस् प्राणमयकोश is of the nature of activity therefore what rajomsha karyatvam therefore it is the product of rajomsha rajo aspect rajasic aspect of sukshma mahabhutas because rajoguna and kriya are connected and pranamaya is kriyatmaka therefore it is product of rajoguna so asya pranamaya koshasya क्रियात्मकत्वेन रजोंश कार्यत्वं भवति नाउ द ऑथर इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग दिस थ्री कोशास विथ डिफरेंट स्टेटस दिस थ्री कोशास द विज्ञानमय कोश मनोमय कोश एंड this pranamaya kosha their description were given they are consisting of vijnana, means buddhi, and therefore vijnanamaya and achadaka, all these were given, details were given. Now these three koshas are given
the hand came on the wire, I think. Therefore.
Okay. Yes. I said, what happened? So these three koshas are given three different status. So now the description of all the three koshas together, each one being given one status, which we are familiar with. So the status which we are familiar, because we are familiar with karta, karana, karya, so that familiar status are given to these three koshas. Ukta koshatrayam anudya tesham pratiniyatam vyavastham darshayati. So Tikakara says, having restated these three koshas, they have got some vyavastha, arrangement, mutual status, pratiniyata, definite, well defined. So these three koshas have got vyavastha, a particular arrangement, that one will be doing this job, other will be doing this job, like that vyavastha is there. So that pratiniyata vyavastha, in terms of the status, that is darshayati, acharya shows. So acharya shows the well-defined vyavastha, arrangement, mutual relationship, mutual status in the next paragraph. Eteshu kosheshu madhye,
Eteshu kosheshu madhye,
vijnanamayah jnana shaktiman kartru rupah,
vijnanamayah jnana shaktiman kartru rupah,
manomayah iccha shaktiman karana rupah,
manomayah iccha shaktiman karana rupah,
pranamayah kriya shaktiman karya rupah, योग्यत्वाद् एवं एतेषां विभागः,
योग्यत्वाद् एव एतेषां विभागः,
इति
वर्णयन्ति
एतत् कोशत्रयम्,
एतत् कोशत्रयम्
मिलितं सत्,
मिलितं सत्
सूक्ष्मशरीरम् इति उच्यते,
सूक्ष्मशरीरम् इति उच्यते,
एतेषु कोशेषु मध्ये, among these koshas, sheets, कोशेषु कोशत्रेषु, so कोशत्रे, त्रिषु कोशेषु, in these three koshas, among these three koshas, विज्ञानमयः, विज्ञानमय कोशः, is ज्ञानशक्तिमान, endowed with jnana shakti, the power of knowledge, and therefore what? Kartru rupaha, therefore it is in the form of an agent. So vijnanamaya kosha has the status of being the agent, because agent can be the one who has got jnanam, who has got jnanam, who has the power to direct the instruments. Buddhi has that. Buddhi has got the knowledge to do something, and Buddhi has got the knowledge to direct the instruments. And therefore, being jnana shaktiman, vijnanamaya kosha is kartru rupaha. And how do you say it is jnana shaktiman? For that Tikakara gave the Shruti basis. There is a Shruti which describes the Atma in Brihadaranyaka 432. 432 or 437, you can check. Yoyam vijnanamayaha praneshu hridi antar jyotihi purushaha iti shrutehe. Is 432 or I will check, one minute, I will check now itself. So this Shruti, Yoyam Vijnanamayaha Praneshu Hridi Antar Jyotihi Purushaha. This is Shruti, where Purusha Atma is presented as Antar Jyoti, inner light, present in the heart, near the pranas, and it is Vijnanamayaha. Vijnana means Vijnanopadikaha. So Vijnana Prayaha. So this Atma is presented as Vijnana Mayaha. And therefore Tikakara says Vijnanasya Chaitanya Prati Atisannihitatvat Jnana Shakti Matvam. So, since Atma is Jnana Swarupa and Buddhi is the closest to it, and therefore Buddhi Vijnanamaya is Jnana Shaktima. Okay. So this is Shruti based Jnana Shaktiman. And also we can see that Buddhi is having this cognition. And Buddhi can have cognition ascertainment only when there is Jnana Shakti. Because any effect is possible when the potential is there. So in Buddhi, Jnanam takes place. And therefore, Buddhi must have this Jnana Shakti. Like walking takes place in the person, so he must have the power of walking. Talking takes place in the person, so talking power must be there. Karyam Shaktim Anumapayati. Any effect will make us infer the power. So, Buddhi Vijnanamaya Kosha has the effect, is endowed with the effect of Jnanam, effect in the form of Jnanam. Therefore, it should have Jnana Shakti. So, Jnana Shaktiman Vijnanamayaha. And Jnana Yukta alone can become Karta. One who has got knowledge alone can do the activities. And therefore, Kartru Rupaha, it is Karta. Now, next one. So, here Vijnanamaya Kosha was given the status of being Karta, and Shruti also. Vijnanam Yajnam Tanute. Tanute means Karoti. Vijnana does Yajna. Karmani Tanoti Cha. Karmani Tanoti. And also he does Karmani, Laukika Karmani. And therefore, Vijnanam Buddhi, Vijnanamaya Kosha, of course with Abhasa, he is given the status of Karta. What about Manaha? Manomayaha Ichha Shaktiman Karana Rupaha. Manomaya is Ichha Shaktiman. It is endowed with Ichha. It is endowed with the power of desiring, not only Ichha. It is endowed with the power of desiring. Because in Brihadaranyaka Shruti, while describing the mind, kama, sankalpa, etat sarvam manaha eva. It's a big list there. Etat sarvam manaha eva. This mantra was quoted in Kenopanishad Bhashyam. So, kama, sankalpa, vichikitsa, etat sarvam manaha eva. So, here, kama was presented as the mind. Therefore, what? Kama parapariyayaha ichchayaha manovrittitvavadharanat ichchashakti matvam. In the Shruti, Kama apara pariyaya icha. Icha, which is having the synonyms of kama, which is described in the Shruti, is ascertained to be manovritti. Etat sarva mana eva. And therefore, this manomayaha, the kosha consisting of the mind, is Ichha Shaktiman. It has got the Ichha. It is endowed with the power of desiring. Here one thing to be noted is that it is not that only Ichha is there in the Manomaya. All emotions are also included. All other emotions, all other things, even Vishaya Karta, being of the shape of the object, that is said to be the function of the mind only. And therefore, it is not only Ichha, but in this context, Ichha Shakti is highlighted. Ichha Shaktiman. So the mind desires, and Buddhi takes the decision whether this desire is proper or not, whether this desire should be fulfilled or not. That Buddhi does. So that's what. Acha. I see, this is because of that power, no?
Okay.
Not by movement. So, manomayaha ichha shaktiman. And it is karana rupaha. It is in the form of karana, instrument. Why? Because buddhi decides and mind implements. So, through the mind, the buddhi is accomplishing. And therefore, mind becomes karana rupa. Even to get the knowledge of the object, this mind goes out. Mind assumes the shape of the object. And therefore, the manomaya is called karana rupa. Why? Buddhi is accomplishing the knowledge, etc. through the manaha. Therefore, mana is what? Karana rupaha. All right. And also, the Tikakara gives that without mind, mere indriyas cannot accomplish the knowledge of the objects. By anvaya vyatireka we see, even though my eyes are open, objects are there in front of that, but still, anyatra manaha abhuvam. If my mind goes somewhere else, then what? Na adarsham. I did not see. In Shruti, this vakya comes. Anyatra manaha abhuvam. Na adarsham. I did not see. Therefore, sometimes you see that this person is with open eyes sitting. You go there and still he is not seeing you. Possible or not? Then these people do like this. they do like this. To draw the attention. So how his eyes are open, sometimes when ears are open, person doesn't hear, even without hearing problem. Why? He is so absorbed in something. It happens. So, Ichha Shaktiman Manomayaha Karana Rupa. So, without mind, even though sense organs and sense objects are there, the perception does not take place. It means the instrument in the form of mind is required. Mind backs up the organs. Then only organs can function. Therefore, karana rupaha. Mind becomes an instrument for perception. All right. And mind only provides the data to buddhi. Then buddhi decides. Buddhi like, officer. Okay, kya data hai? What are the data? Then okay, this not correct. Why are you bringing wrong data? So mind says okay, next time careful. So we can visualize something like this. Anyway, so karana rupaha. I hope we got the idea. So manomayaha ichha shaktiman karana rupaha. Okay. Then pranamayaha is kriya shaktiman. Pranamayaha is endowed with kriya shakti, because these all activities are happening because of prana, so prana must have kriya shakti. श्रुति आल्सो इज गिवन हियर स यथा प्रयोग्य आचरते युक्तः एवमस्य अस्मिन् शरीरे प्राणो युक्तः. सो इन दिस बॉडी प्राण इज देयर, देयरफॉर पर्सन डज द एक्टिविटी. सो द श्रुति इज देयर एंड देयरफॉर वी से क्रिया शक्तिमान प्राणमयः. ओके, सो प्राणमय इज एंडोड विद द पावर ऑफ एक्शन बेस्ड ऑन द श्रुति एंड कार्य रूपः. इट इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ प्रोडक्ट. सो थ्री थिंग्स ही वांट्स टू टेल, कर्ता, करण एंड कार्य. कार्य मीन्स प्रोडक्ट एंड दिस ऑल्सो इज बेस्ड ऑन श्रुति. श्रुति वाक्य इज देयर, तौ मिथुनम समेताम ततः प्राणः अजायत. दिस वाक एंड मनस हैड द कॉम्बिनेशन एंड प्राण वॉज बॉर्न. सो दिस इज जस्ट श्रुति बेस्ड डिस्क्रिप्शन दैट प्राण इज बॉर्न. वी हैव गॉट अदर वाक्यास, एतस्मात् जायते प्राण आल्सो इज देयर. प्राण इज कार्य रूप. प्राण इज कंसिडर्ड टू बी कार्यम, प्रोडक्ट. All right. So we have three karya, karana and karta, karana and karya, and three things are there. So we are matching. In fact, other two are also karya, but this has got a karana status and kartru status is not there, and therefore karya is left out. But otherwise, other two also are karya. Okay. So pranamayaha kriya shaktiman karya rupaha. But this pranamaya becoming karya rupaha, this description is not found very often. Prana is karya, no doubt. Prana is karya rupaha. But just as the manomaya is highlighted as a karana and vijnanamaya is highlighted as a karta, in that manner, this pranamaya is not so much, I have not seen so much being highlighted as a karya rupaha. Why? Because karya rupatvam samanyat, therefore it is not highlighted. But since there three are there and three status are to be are being given, therefore these two are taken away by vijnanamaya and manomaya. So pranamaya is left out. Okay, prana is okay, okay. Whatever left out you give me, you take away whatever you want. So prana is very mature, you know. Therefore pranamaya karya rupaha. All right. Pranamaya is a kriya shaktiman, no? So he does things. He says, I don't care for the title. So, kriya shaktiman, kari rupa. This is in lighter way, okay? Then, he said, this type of division, how can you do it? Yogyatva deva. Based on the appropriateness. Yogyatvad, based on the appropriateness. Evam, in this manner. एतेषां, एतेषां मीन्स विज्ञानमय मनोमय प्राणमयानां कोशानां विभागः, देयर इज अ डिविजन इति, इन दिस मैनर वर्णयन्ति, वर्णयन्ति हि विद्वांसः, दि स्कॉलरली पीपल, लर्नेड पीपल प्रेजेंट. योग्यत्वा, सो दिस कर्ता, करण एंड कार्य, this division is based on yogyatva. They have got appropriate requirements, appropriate basis. Vijnanamaya is kartrupa because it has got jnanam, it has got this ahankara, and therefore vijnanamaya has got yogyata. And similarly manomaya has got this Ichha Shakti Matva, and it has got this, the require, it is a requirement for having the status of Karana. So based on the appropriateness alone, this type of division is there. So Yogyatva Deva. So it is not random division, it is based on the appropriateness of each one of them. Etesham Vibhagaha. Etesham is Koshat. त्रयाणाम कोशानाम विभागः इति वर्णयन्ति. इन दिस मैनर दिस स्कॉलरली लर्नेड पीपल वर्णयन्ति. ऑल राइट. Then, etat koshatrayam melitam satu. These three koshas together, melitam is together. This group of three koshas together, being together, sat means being. This group of three koshas being together means when these three koshas are referred together, then sukshma shariram is a subtle body. Iti, in this manner, uchyate, it is told, it is presented in Shastra. So these three koshas, when referred together, seen together, then it is referred to as sukshma shariram, subtle body. So subtle body is consisting of these three koshas. Alright. Now, sukshma sharira also has got samashti vyashti division. That is being said from the next, in the next sentence, next paragraph. Atra api,
atra api
akhila sukshma shariram,
akhila sukshma shariram
eka
buddhi vishayataya
vanavat
jalashaya vadva
jalashaya vadva
samashtihi
aneka buddhi vishayataya vrukshavad jalavadva vyashtihi api bhavati. So in sukshma sharira also vyashti samashti bheda is there. Individual total division can be seen. Now first he makes the division, at the end he will say both are one. That's what our approach is to. You acknowledge the division, at the same time see, don't lose sight of fundamental essential oneness. See both. That is the beauty, that is the maturity. See the difference, but don't lose sight of essential oneness. So that's why he says that here now division is making. Afterwards he will say abhedaha in the 96. So 96 he will say abhedaha samashti vyashtoho vyashtyoho. Okay. Atrapi, even in this regard. Atrapi iti asya ko artha?
Even with regard to sukshma shari.
Sukshma sharire. Sukshma sharire vishaye. So with regard to the subtle body, atrapi sukshma sharire vishaye, even with regard to sukshma sharira, akhila sukshma shariram, the entire sukshma sharira, the entire subtle body, eka buddhi vishayataya, originally it is one only, akhila sukshma shariram, the entire the subtle body, eka buddhi vishayataya, from the standpoint of, or as an object of single idea. Eka buddhi means single idea. As an object of single idea, it is what? Samashtihi. We have to connect with samashtihi. The entire subtle body, as an object of single idea, it is samashtihi. We have seen this with reference to Agdanam. I can look upon this clip with one thought. This is a clip, only one clip. But if I go to the, I might now focus on different parts, then I say this is a manifold object, having many facets. So when I look upon this clip as with one idea, then it is only one clip, samashti clip. And when I look upon this same object as an object of many thoughts, I am seeing top, I am seeing bottom, I am seeing middle, I am seeing side. So when this object is becoming the object of many thoughts, then each one becomes what? Vyashti. When I see this clip as an object of only one thought, it is samashti. So that is what is said here. Atra akhila sukshma shariram eka buddhi vishayataya, as an object of one buddhi. That's why we have seen earlier, you can think of your body as one body. In one sweep of attention, in one go, when you are thinking of this body, it is just one body. But then, when you visualize different parts, then it is manifold. So each part will become vyashti. So that is said here, eka buddhi vishayataya akhila sukshma shariram samashtihi bhavati. So what is highlighted is, it is a matter of standpoint. Akhila buddhi means a particular, the standpoint of totality. Eka buddhi vishaya means the standpoint of oneness, totality. Then it is seen as samashtihi. So eka buddhi vishaya means as an object of single thought, single idea. Then it is samashtihi. And aneka buddhi vishayataya, as an object of many ideas, means it is seen from different angles, focusing on the parts, then vyashtihi api bhavati, then akhila sukshma sharira becomes vyashti, individual also. Bhavati means becomes, vyashti api means individual, api also. So the sukshma sharira as such, the entire sukshma sharira can be seen as one samashti, or it can be seen as many vyashtis. In simple words, this entire sukshma sharira can be seen as one totality, or it can be seen as many individual subtle bodies. Alright. Now, he gives the example, vanavat jalashayavadva. Just as all the trees you see eka buddhi vishayataya, then it is what? Vana, forest, one forest. So all the aggregate of trees as eka buddhi vishaya, as an object of one idea, one thought, then what? Ekam vanam is seen as one forest. Or another example, jalashaya vadva. There are so many waves and forms and the wavelets, but you see all of them as an object of one thought, then jalashaya. Jalashaya means reservoir, water body. Then it is one only. So all the waters, when seen as an object of one single idea, then it is one jalashaya, one water body. And that will be what? Samashtihi. As an object of one idea, it is samashtihi. As an object of the many ideas, it is vyashtihi. So just as one vana is a samashti, being the object of single thought, jalashaya is the samashti, being the object of this single idea. Similarly, akhila sukshma, the sukshma sharira, when it is the object of single idea, it is samashtihi. And aneka buddhi vishayataya, being the object of many ideas, it becomes vyashti. For that example is what? Vrukshavat jalavadva. When many that trees, aggregate of trees is there, and you are seeing it from many angles, many thoughts are there. So there, aneka buddhi vishayataya vrukshaha. Each individual tree will be seen as many entities. So vyashti api bhavati. When you are seeing all the trees from the stand as an object of many thoughts, then the trees will be seen as vyashtihi. And how many vyashti? Many vyashtihi. Aneka vyashtihi api bhavati. Similarly, jalavat. You see this water from the standpoint of this top, bottom, etc., or what type of shape it has got. It has got a wave shape or wavelet shape or a foam shape, whirlpool shape. then if you are thinking in that direction, then it becomes what? Aneka buddhi vishaya. When it becomes aneka buddhi vishaya, then same water becomes vyashtihi, many vyashtihi. So these two examples are given. Vana is samashti example, jalasha is samashti example, vruksha and jala are vyashti example. Alright. Now, Chaitanyam, which is endowed with samashti sukshma sharira, or having the upadhi of samashti sukshma sharira, then it gets various titles. That is given in the next sentence. Etat samashtyupahitam chaitanyam.
Etat samashtyupahitam chaitanyam.
Sutratma hiranyagarbha pranaha cha iti uchyate.
Sutratma hiranyagarbha pranaha cha iti uchyate.
Sarvatra anusyutatvat.
Sarvatra anusyutatvat.
Nanechha kriya shakti badupahitatvat cha. एतत् समष्ट्युपहितं चैतन्यम्. एतत् रेफर्स् टु सूक्ष्म शरीर. सूक्ष्म शरीर समष्टि उपहितं चैतन्यम्. कॉन्शियसनेस विच इज उपहित कंडीशन्ड बाय द असोसिएट एडजंक्ट विच इज सूक्ष्म शरीर समष्टि. The totality of subtle body, consciousness conditioned by the adjunct in the form of total subtle body is uchyate, is called sutratma. Sutratma is a word used in the shastra. Sutratma literally means thread atma. Sutra means thread. So, Atma, which is like a thread. What is the speciality of thread? Thread is in and through all the flowers in the garland. And therefore, this Chaitanyam with Samashti Sukshma Sharira Upadhi, being in and through all the living beings, present in all the living beings, therefore it is called Sutratma. The reason will be given. Sarvatra Anusyutatvat Sutratma. So we have to connect like this. Etas samashtyupahitam chaitanyam sarvatra anusyutatvat sutratma. Consciousness with total subtle body is called sutratma because sarvatra, in all living beings, anusyutatvat, being inherently present, invariably present. Then it is called Hiranyagarbha and Prana. It is called Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyam Tadupalakshita Jnanam Sarvagdanam Garbhe Yasya Saha. So Hiranyagarbha is the one who has got Hiranyam, gold. Gold means shining. Shining means all knowledge. Garbhe, inside. One who has got gold like all knowledge inside whom is called Hiranyagarbha. Hiranyam Sarvagnanam Garbhe Yasya Saha Hiranyagarbha. And why? Because Jnana Shakti Yuktatvat and Pranaha Cha. It is called Prana also. Why? Kriya Shakti Madupahitatvat. Because it is conditioned by the upadhi of the power of action. Kriya Shakti Mat Upahitatvat. It is conditioned by the upadhi which is endowed with the power of action. Therefore it is called Prana. Icha can be taken into Sutratma also. If we go by this Parishesha, Hiranyagarbha took away Dana Shakti, Prana took away Kriya Shakti, then Sutratma can have Icha Shakti. But generally, this Sutratma and Icha Shakti are not connected. Sutratma is used, the word is used to show the Anusyuta Swabhava. But Icha Shakti is of course there in Hiranyagarbha and Prana both. In the all three of them are the same. Only three titles are there. So All of them, Sutratma, Hiranyagarbha, Prana are the names for Samashti, Sukshma, Sharira, Upahitam, Chaitanyam. It gets these three names based on different hetus. Sarvatra Anusyutatva Sutratma and Gnanecha Kriya Shakti Madupahitatvat Hiranyagarbha Pranaha Cha. That way also we can take. So three names are there for consciousness endowed with or conditioned by the upadhi of Samashti Sukshma Sharira, total subtle body. Sutratma, Hiranyagarbha and Prana. More about this, see in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah.